Please welcome his opponent from Bishop Auckland, Callum Elkanon Walton. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky.
Bit of a buzz about the debutant from Bishop Auckland. A man who had a handful of amateur fights, 30 or so, is turning professional today. And a man with the nickname Elkanon says he loves to be a counterpuncher, but an aggressive one. Let's see how aggressive he fancies being on his debut in front of a lot of family and friends who've made the short journey down from Bishop Auckland to support him this evening.
And I think I died in an accident, cause this must be heaven. I gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Now let's take them.
Live from Newcastle, Phil Jeffries presents 4 3-minute rounds in the super middleweight division. Your referee, Neil Close. Introducing first in the blue corner, wearing the black shorts, weighing in at 168 pounds. Tonight he enters the ring for the sixth time. From Croatia, Zdenko Bulej. And his opponent in the red corner, wearing the white and pink, weighing in at 169 pounds. Tonight he makes his professional debut. From Bishop Auckland, Callum Elkanon.
Okay, both boxers, you both know the rules of boxing. Keep your heads up, keep your punches up. I want nothing on the back of the head. Obey my commands at all times, defend yourselves at all times. Touch gloves. Back your corner.
Well, after the first round stoppage last time, let's see what Callum Walton can bring up here against young Zdenko Bulej from Croatia. Walton in the white trunks against Bulej in the black. Bit of a buzz developing about young Callum Walton, who hasn't even had a pro fight before this evening. And he's charismatic, he's fun, kind of guy that's got a smile on his face. And he's looking to make some waves here against Zdenko Bulej. Little acknowledgement there from the Croatian as that right hand got through.
He was a bit of a character yesterday at the weigh-in, Bulej. They were on the wrong side for the photographs. He was laughing and all smiles. But again, it's just good experience for Walton, having a weigh-in the day before you fight. A lot of these prospects turning pro, they just get told to weigh in on the day to save on the expenses for the promoter and everything else. So he got a chance to go through the full setup day before weigh-in. Press conference, photo shoots, everything that comes with being a professional boxer.
Look like the kind of guy that's going to thrive in that spotlight as well, Walton. Doesn't matter about any of that though, it's what you can do. It's all about getting the job done in the ring. That's Bulej. Set his stall out early here. He's a guy who has just come to survive, get the rounds, get the job done, and plan for the next fight.
Normally the type of opponents that you're fighting at this level in your debut, they're genuine just survivors. I think there's a little bit here with Boulay that you can capitalize on if you want. That was a nice body shot. You see a little grimace in his face as it landed to acknowledge that it got home. But as I say, I think there's a good chance here that Walton could stop Boulay. He's open a little bit too much for me.
Well, he did get tagged on his debut, inside around. He's certainly using the full circumference of this ring, isn't he, to try and stay out of trouble.
That's a little bit of what I'm getting at as well, Nick. You know, he's wasting a lot of energy, and you won't get journeymen coming over here dancing around rings. They survive, they tuck up, you know, they don't take too much stick, but they don't also exert a lot of energy, and Boulay is exerting a lot of energy and moving a lot of, you know, he's putting miles on the clock, so to speak. He's doing laps of the ring, as you say, and he won't do that for four rounds.
Yeah, what Walton doesn't want to get dragged into is just plodding around the ring after him. If he can start cutting off the ring, making it small, he can make life pretty uncomfortable for Boulay, who didn't look very happy at all in that first round. I'm sure that's exactly what they were saying in his corner. Don't go chasing after this fella.
Yeah.
Cut it down, cut the distance, cut across him.
The basics, as what we always say, you know, the basics and the fundamentals. If someone's circling the ring, don't follow them, step across, cut it off of them, make that a smaller place. But sometimes it is easier said than done.
Yes.
And you have to be capable enough to actually carry out the orders. Good left hook there from Walton.
Yeah, if he can just apply some pressure with that front foot of his, Walton, he can make life very, very uncomfortable for Boulay, who's got the game plan, knows exactly what he wants here. I think he learned a lesson from that debut in Switzerland when he got wiped out inside a round, and he said, well, I'm not going to last very long in this game if I'm going to get caught like that. And since then, it's all about survival. But he looks pretty good at it. Marking up a bit around the left eye there with Croatian.
Well, listen, he's coming to fight. He's not here to survive. Boulay, if he could not get stopped, great, but he's leaving loads of openings and more than enough inviting openings for Walton to land. He's feeling the pace of this fight already. As I say, as you mentioned, Nick, because of all the movement that he's putting in, and I think it's only a matter of time before Walton gets a stoppage. It could be this round. It definitely should be the next one. Body shots especially. You can see the grimace in Boulay's face every time he's touched downstairs to the body.
Yeah, he doesn't like it at all, does he?
And, good shot.
Yeah. Catching him with the jab as well. And he is slowing, that's the thing for Boulay, and you talked about he's not going to be able to keep up laps of the ring through four rounds, and he really is slowing. The body shot gets in the left hook, and that will probably be the end of that. He's not getting up from that. It was a vicious shot. It really was. Surprised they're even counting this. That was over the moment he hit the floor. That was a vicious hook. It really was. He's still down, Boulay. Oh. Well, he's up now, straight down onto his stool. That's the good news, but that's one of those that as soon as the guy goes down, you know, that's it, game, set and match.
You could see the grimace on the shot and the pain etched on his face whenever any little light shot would land. So you knew as soon as one decent shot was going to land down there to the body, he was going to not be able to withstand it, obviously, which he did. You know, I felt it was maybe a tiny bit of dramatics in at the end, but good shot from Walton and Callum Walton.
You called it. You were saying 30 seconds earlier, yeah, he could stop him here.
He could, because the opens were there. You could see how high his elbows were coming. It's a good shot. It was actually a little bit round the back, but it was a good shot. A nice shot from Callum Walton, and it's an actual knockout, an actual KO, a 10 count on your debut. It doesn't get much better.
Well, that's the perfect debut, absolutely perfect debut. As you say, it's a 10 count, but he could have counted to 50. This fellow wasn't getting up.
No, when we were talking earlier in previous fights with previous prospects, and we say you have to dress these shots up. He touches the head with a right uppercut just before he lands the left hook to the body. That did all the damage. And it's nice to see, obviously, up and down, down and up. Touch the head first, then bang the body, go to the body first, then caught the head, then back to the body. It's not just one big shot trying to knock him out, but a lot to work on, a lot to build on, should I say, for Callum Walton. But impressive professional debut for him, and long may it continue.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Neil Close calls a stop the action at 2 minutes and 21 seconds of round number 2. For your winner by knockout, the journey starts now, Callum Elkanon Walton!
Callum is posing for interviews at the moment, but hopefully we'll grab him in a moment. But that's quite an entourage he got there. But I think he's ready, so I'll see if I can go and grab him. Callum, congratulations. Is that exactly what you were hoping for tonight, a first-round stoppage?
It was second round, but, yeah, exactly what I was dreaming of, to be honest.
It was a second round, yeah. I'm getting completely confused there, but, yeah, a perfect stoppage, wasn't it? Is that one of your signature shots, the hook to the body?
Yeah, that's what I've been working on. We work on it a lot, and Alex and Simon, guys always say, let it go and you'll stop people, and, I mean, look what happened.
Tell us about this nickname of yours, Elkanon. Where does that come from?
It's all down to this man, really.
You all get a nickname. Everyone in the gym gets a nickname. He's elaborated on his, though it was the Cannon, but he's changed it to Elkanon. A bit more glamorous.
I love it. What's the plan now? Are you just going to go out and have some fun tonight, or is it you straight back in the gym tomorrow, straight down to business again?
I'm going to go get a Chinese, but I'll probably be in the gym tomorrow. I'll be in the gym tomorrow, but I'm going to pick it out tonight.
Well, you've earned it. Bring some back for me as well, will you?
Cheers. Thank you. Thanks, everyone, for coming out as well. What a turnout, eh?
A very popular winner tonight, Callum Walton.